Hi everyone and welcome back to Cut the Kibble. Today I'd like to share with you one of my breakfast casseroles that I make for my dog. And the protein in this is eggs. Yes, eggs. Eggs is a very healthy food for dogs. And what I do is I do egg casseroles for the morning, because hey, it's breakfast. And for the nighttime, I either do beef, turkey, or salmon as the protein. This varies the diet for the dogs, and it also cuts down a little on cost because meat can be very expensive. So here we go. All right, I have everything out here for you. And the first thing I'm gonna put in this egg casserole is sardines. Now, you gotta be careful. This is one good thing about you cooking. You control what goes in the food and where it is sourced. I use sardines in every single meal. And the best ones that I can find are at Trader Joe's. And I'll come over here so you can see it better. These are sardines only in water. And they are from Canada. And there's no salt in it, okay? I recently heard people using anchovies, which I don't know the difference. And I bought these anchovies, but they are in salt. You would have to definitely rinse that off. And where are they sourced again? Oh geez, I forgot where they were sourced, but I thought it was fine. Well, I can't find it right now. But anyway, you always have to read your labels. I'm not gonna use these anymore because it has salt in it. And I don't use salt. So I'm gonna put this in the side. Don't forget, when you go to the store, you have to get sardines that are soaked only in water. Do not get oil. And look at the source. You don't wanna buy things like, I don't even buy sardines from San Diego anymore because with the nuclear power plant that exploded in Japan, there's been maps showing that nuclear waste has reached San Diego. So I'm not gonna risk it. Not risking it for the brisket, as they say. Now, I only use half a can of sardines per casserole. So there's one, two, three. Three sardines go in there. The rest of this can I will freeze for another time. Okay, let me put this to the side. And let's see, what else am I gonna put in here now? Now I wanted to talk to you about the vegetables to put in. You need to be careful what vegetables you put in because you don't wanna use high starchy vegetables. High starchy vegetables are green beans, peas, carrots, beets, high starch because sugar. You want to use low starchy vegetables. And the low starchy vegetables that I'm using today are asparagus and green squash, zucchini. And I could do another video about it, but I actually bought these fresh and roasted them myself and then packaged them up and froze them for later use. But hey, if you want to buy frozen, there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. Just make sure you know where the source is. Even Whole Foods sells frozen vegetables from China. You don't want to buy anything from China. So I'm putting in, I had microwaved these because they were frozen. I added a little water and I'm putting the water in here as well. Now, the next thing I'm going to put in are sweet potatoes. And I know that some of you are going to come back to me and say, well, that's a high starchy vegetable. I'm only going to use a little, and sweet potato is so healthy with beta carotene that you got to use some. So here's my sweet potato, and I'm going to show you how much I'm putting in. I don't measure. I'm sorry. I'm not one of those type of cooks. So I would say this is maybe like a third of a cup of sweet potato that goes in. And I'll save this other sweet potato for another day. Okay, now the next thing I'm gonna put in, is the beef liver cakes. Remember we made those the last video. So basically have 3 1/2. 1, 2, and these are little ones, 3 1/2. I defrosted them and I have blueberries. I try to buy organic blueberries because blueberries is one of the dirty dozen of fruits and vegetables that has pesticides in it. And at Costco, they have frozen organic blueberries. So those go in. The next thing I'm gonna add is, I like to add something to stretch the recipe out. I don't do rice. I was doing quinoa, but that does have protein in it. Plus my dog doesn't really digest it. It comes out the way it went in. I do oatmeal. I cook up oats, and I do beans. Oh, I know I'm gonna get some people squawking about that, about the DCM. There's no proof about that. There's a lot of controversy. I've been doing rotating pinto beans or garbanzo beans in for over the last 10 or so years, and my dogs don't have any heart issues, okay? So please don't make a comment about that. But today, what I'm gonna do, because I actually made this for myself, I found some Barilla chickpea pasta. And the only ingredient in it, look at this, it's so awesome. I'm gonna come over to you so you can see it. I don't know if you can see it, it says ingredient, chickpea flour. So all it is chickpeas that they made into a flour to make the pasta. You could try it yourself if you like it. I find it to be a little heavy, but my daughter who's a vegetarian loves it. I'm gonna put 1/2 cup in here. Okay, that's done. And of course, what do we always put in our food? Garlic. 1 little clove of garlic. It's not a lot, people. It's good for them. Garlic in small amounts are good. Ginger. I don't normally use ginger, but I had it. And I'm going to use this stupid zester again. If anybody knows of a great zester, or I should say microplaner, could you please put that in the comments below, because I have probably bought 4 of these microplaners and I am not having luck with much of them. Okay, let's just do a little bit more. Got that in there, Sister Sally. Moving along. Next thing I'm gonna put, well, you know I like putting parsley. Parsley is good for fresh breath. And I'm just gonna cut off a little, not much. Definitely wash it. And that's going in. All right, moving these away so I know what I've done and what I haven't done. And the next thing I'm gonna put in is I'll come over here, raw pumpkin seeds that I got at Trader Joe's. Oh, it's raining. It hasn't rained in 2 months, thank goodness. And organic flaxseed that I also got at Trader Joe's. And what I do to make it easier for me and quicker, because I'm all about doing this and moving on with my life, even though I love cooking, is I put both of them, the pumpkin seeds and the flax seeds, into a Vitamix, and I grind it up. So I have, it's a quick step, and it's a powder form. Then it goes into a powder form, okay? And I just put like a teaspoon and a half in, all right? And then I always put seaweed calcium into all of my recipes for the actual recipes, not for the treats. You can buy this on Amazon. And you're supposed to use 1 teaspoon per pound of protein and sprinkle that in. Now I do add a probiotic, but the probiotic cannot be put into this recipe because you cannot bake the probiotic in the oven. And actually I always heat up all my food in the microwave. You cannot heat it up. So I add the probiotic right before I'm gonna give it to the dog. All right, so the probiotic, no, not the probiotic, the seaweed calcium. Okay, so now you basically have everything in. Before I put the eggs in, I'm gonna get my top on. And I don't have it plugged in. So hold on 1 second, let me plug this in. Okay, and I'm gonna process it a little. And then I'm gonna add, I didn't need to take that off. I have a love-hate relationship with food processors. I'm gonna add like 3 eggs. 1, 2, 3, whoop, 4 got in there. Pulse it a little. And add some more. 1, 2, 3. And add the remainder. And let it rip for a little bit. Okay, you just need to mix it until everything is mixed together. Now, one reason I process everything is that both of my dogs, well, my other dog has passed away now, they don't have a lot of teeth. Bella is missing 19 teeth. So I do process it, but I find that one, when you cook your vegetables, and two, when you process them, it's much easier on their digestion. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is I have a nice casserole dish here. It's one of my favorite ones. And I'm gonna move this out. Give me 1 second, because I want you to see what I'm doing. Get rid of this food processor. And I always oil my pans with coconut oil. Again, I get this at Costco also. I love Costco, as you can see. But whatever you do, wherever you get your coconut oil, you wanna make sure that it's organic and that it's virgin and it's cold press. Cold press means, even in olive oil, it's the first press, okay? Because all the other presses, they're processing it. This has not been processed. And so what I do, and Bella has now smelled that I opened the coconut oil, so she's gonna wanna have some. So I'm gonna just give her a little bit. Here you go, sweetie. Sorry, you can't see that. And I get a towel, I put the towel in the pan, and I just oil the pan. And I just do that so that it's easy cleanup for me after. Okay. I also give Bella a teaspoon of coconut oil per day. It's very good for her coat. It's also good for not having fleas on her. It's good for her skin. It's just very healthy, but you don't want to use a lot, just like a teaspoon. Again, my dog is almost 12 pounds. It's not a big dog. If you have a bigger dog, you'll have to look to see how much to give. All right, so now I'm just gonna pour all this into my coconut oil grease casserole dish. Take the blade out. Get every last drop in here. Okay, and I'm gonna bake this. I'm gonna bake it at 350 for maybe 23, 25 minutes and check that it is set inside. Put my timer up to 23 and I can go back and see it. And after that's cooked, I'm going to let it cool. And then I'm gonna get these Ziploc bags that I had used for freezing all my vegetables that I used. And I'm gonna get a half a cup measure, because that's how much my dog eats at 11, 12 pounds, and put it in here. Put all of them on a tray, flash freeze them, and go from there. Also, I have other things I've tried to use. I've used these to put my food in. I got them at Wegmans or Costco, the grocery store, but I don't like them because they're not really reusable. They crack after a few times, even though it's for freezer safe. So ask me any questions if you want. I hope that you enjoyed this video. All right, thank you. And you know what? The rain stopped. It only lasted 2 minutes. We really need rain here in Virginia.